Our world is filled with numerous amounts of resources and materials, some which manifest themselves as earth-grown, and others as products of industrial manufacture. Natural or man-made, the question still remains. Are we really using them efficiently and to their full potential? To put the answer into perspective, I'd like you all to look at the numbers on the screen. 1, 9, 2. I'll be showing you, according to a United Nations report, the amount of waste in kilograms the world produces on average every year. We'll be doing that by adding zeros to the numbers next to me. So let's start with 3. Raise your hands if you believe this is the amount. Anyone? Okay. 3 more zeros. How about another 3 zeros? Raise your hands if you think this is the amount. Unfortunately, the answer is no. 1 more zero. That, ladies and gentlemen, is roughly the amount of waste we dump every year. 1.92 trillion kilograms of waste. Just imagine how big that number is. As you can see, the answer to our previous question is a staggering no. And as one of the many members of the youth who will one day take up the mantle as caregivers to our nation, I wanted to change that. Today, I'll be sharing with you the story of how my team and I at the Emirates Foundation tackled this global issue. When we look around us, we can find plastic, water, glass at almost every corner. In fact, if you look around you right now, you'll be able to find at least one of these materials. As an example, the windows right next to you. So my team and I, at the time, decided to work with these very sources: wastewater, plastic, and glass. We wanted to transform them, make something big, something not only our nation, but the entire world can benefit from. As many of you may know, we will in fact wake up one day with no fossil fuels left. And we know that fossil fuels are the main source of energy. It's estimated that by the year 2088, all forms of fossil fuels will indeed go extinct. Now, whether that's true or not depends on how careful we are. And if not given enough importance, that day might come even sooner than we all think. Thus, we decided to focus our work on developing alternative ways to generate clean electricity and energy through non-polluting and cheaper methods. Our first project focused on how wastewater could be used to generate clean electricity and energy. Wastewater is basically any type of impure water you could think of, whether it was sewage water or even polluted water. Now, wastewater is found in literally every single country around the world. Unfortunately, these bodies of water can be extremely and highly dangerous because of the amount of bacteria, pathogens, and other materials they contain. But what if? What if we could find a way to not only purify the wastewater, but also use it to generate electricity and energy to power millions of houses, buildings, centers, anything you can think of, really? What if? Well, we did. Our answer was the microbial fuel cell. So here's a simple and brief explanation of how it worked. Electricity is essentially the flow of electrons through a circuit, and wastewater contains special bacteria that generate these electrons when they react with the other materials found in wastewater. These electrons then pass from one half cell to another half cell through these rods known as electrodes. The water is then passed through two layers of filter made with carbon nanotube. and those filters trap in the microbes and unwanted materials, yet they allow the water to pass through. As you can see, with only 1 liter of wastewater, we were able to produce a highest average of 0.36 millivolts. Now you can imagine how much more we could produce with thousands and thousands of liters of wastewater if the fuel cell was scaled up. With this method, we can supply a large amount of clean electricity and energy, as well as purified water for agriculture. For our second project, we wanted to change plastic and glass into energy sources. So we used the same material found in plastic water bottles, also known as PET plastic, and onto that we added a special paste. Now this paste has the ability to absorb sunlight and generate that heat into electrical energy. So basically what we did is we produced cheap plastic solar cells, or as many of you may know them, solar panels. As for the glass, we made transparent solar cells. Just imagine all glass surfaces you could think of, from the windows on skyscrapers, the screens of your phone, glass doors, etc., etc. And now imagine that all of those are actual solar cells that provide you with the electricity and the energy that you need. So the moment you walk out of the house with your phone is being charged. You don't have to worry anymore about running out of battery. I mean, isn't that great? We don't have to worry about seeing that red color on the battery sign the next time we open our phone and freak out, because that's not going to happen. Not only that, but now you do not even have to worry about the electricity supply at home. Because all the windows that you have, all glass surfaces that you have, are now solar cells that provide you and supply you with that electricity that you need. Now, in order for us to make all of that come to life, we had to create two different layers, each with its own purpose. The first layer was responsible for absorbing the light, whether it was natural or artificial, and the second layer was responsible for generating that heat to electrical energy that we can use. Now, I'd like you all to imagine a world where wastewater that everyone wanted to get rid of in any way possible, even if that meant polluting the environment they lived in and harming themselves, is now an actual source of clean electricity. And most of the plastic and glass used are now solar cells that supply you with electricity and energy. Imagine a world where you do not have to worry anymore about waking up one day with no fuel left. Why, do you ask? Because now we have efficient alternatives that substitute the diminishing fuel. By changing our perspectives towards the materials around us, we were able to change wastewater from waste to resource. We were able to change plastic and glass from materials merely used in bottles and cups to, again, actual sources of electricity and energy. We were able to change our small team of young hopefuls to scientists that competed nationally and internationally, and alhamdulillah won several awards. I hope that one day our ideas will find use in our country, and perhaps another day in many countries around the world. Our main aim was to shift the perception of waste material so that we could drive our species into a cleaner, more energy-efficient future. But what we really wish to do, what we really wish to do is to inspire the Emirati youth and the entire youth in general to become individuals who have a passion to solve problems, who think differently and globally, and want to make this world a better one. Because all it takes to begin, is a change in your perspective. Thank you all for listening.